Hey everybody, I am back for a quick video. Today we're going to do a rundown of all of the passive income that I earned in April 2020. I have to preface this by saying that this is income earned, not all of this is income realized, okay? Also, there's a lot of apps that I use to get cash back or rebates of various sorts. And if you are not using any of these apps, I have referral links for most of them down in the description box below, if that's something that you would like to look into. My goal here on my YouTube channel is to show how I am reaching financial independence to retire early. I love the FIRE movement, that's why I'm here. So part of that is showing y'all what I do with money that I earn every month. So for April 2020, we'll start first with my investments and savings accounts. I have a taxable investing account as well as a Roth IRA with M1 Finance. I love and use them. Referral link down below for them if y'all are looking for a place to begin investing. In my taxable account, I earned $1.36 from dividends, and I did actually have positive growth for the month of April, and the growth for my taxable account totaled $121.75. My Roth IRA, I did not earn any dividends for April, but I did get positive growth there as well. That account grew $538.67. My 403b retirement account I have at work also had positive growth there. It is a larger account, so this was a lot of growth for 1 month. It grew $8,463.85 for April. I have a savings account at a local credit union. It earned me one penny. And I have a higher yield savings account with betterment.com, and it earned 56 cents for April. So in total, for all of my savings and investments, I earned $9,126.20. Not bad at all. Moving on to the apps that I use for cashback and rebates, Ibotta, I earned $2.50. Rakuten, I earned $14.47. Which is a lot for me for Rakuten. I typically will use Ibotta over Rakuten. I only use Rakuten if Ibotta doesn't have the store that I'm looking for. And I happened to look when I signed up for Mint Mobile just to see if there was anything online as far as rebates go. Ibotta did not have Mint Mobile listed, but there was a sign up bonus through Rakuten. If you're a new account that signs up for Mint Mobile, they would give you $10 back. So I used Rakuten when I signed up with Mint Mobile. And the other $4.47, I believe, was a Chewy order that I had placed. Next is Fetch Rewards. It's a grocery receipt scanning app, and you can also send them e-receipts as well from like Amazon and different stores. They give you points that you earn. And in April, I earned 677 points, which has a monetary value of 68 cents. Coin Out is a very plain Jane receipt scanning app. They accept any type of receipt. You take a picture of it and submit it, and they will give you a few cents for every receipt you submit. And in April, I earned $1.50 from them. Get Upside is a fuel savings app that I use. Every time I get gas for my car, they will give me a certain amount per gallon that I buy. And in April, I earned $4.69 through GetUpside. Google Opinion Rewards is an app that I keep on my phone. It's a survey app, and every once in a while, Google will send me a survey to fill out. It's always just a few questions, and if they send you the survey, you automatically qualify for it, so there's no wasted time here. And it's very easy to use, but in April, they didn't send me any surveys, so I did not earn anything from Google Opinion Rewards. So in total for my apps that I use, I earned $23.84 in April. It adds up, every little bit counts, y'all. Next section is my side hustle slash referral links slash affiliates that I have down in the description box below. And now that my YouTube channel is monetized, I do earn some AdSense money from Google. So for April, I earned $34.25 from this YouTube channel. Thanks y'all for watching and liking and commenting and doing all of the things. Next is Earnest. They are the company that I used when I refinanced my student loans, and I always have a referral link for them down in the description box below because I really like them. And anytime somebody uses that referral link, they'll get $200 and I get $200 for the referral as well. But I did not have anybody use that in April, so that was zero. Next is Thrive Market. It's an online grocery store that delivers to your home. They have all organic and ethically sourced products. I feel like their prices are very fair, so I always link to them below as well, but nobody used that link in April, so zero earned there. And for M1 Finance, whoever you are out there, I had my first M1 Finance referral ever. So yay for that. I got $10 for someone using my link down below to sign up for M1 Finance. I hope whoever you are that you enjoy it as much as I do. And lastly, 1UP Nutrition. 1UP Nutrition is a website for bodybuilders, fitness enthusiasts, and they have some supplements on their site that I like to use. So I always leave a referral link for them below if anyone is interested. And I had no one use that link in April, so that was zero as well. So in total for my referrals, side hustle, affiliate links, I earned $44.25 in April. And credit card rewards, y'all know that I am an advocate of responsible credit card use. And if you can use them responsibly, then I feel that you should take advantage of some of the cashback rewards or travel points that you can earn when you use credit cards. So my primary card that I use is a Bank of America cashback card, and in April I earned $17.99. And my other card that I use is a Chase Amazon Rewards card, and from them I earned $2.82 in April. Total there is $20.81 earned from credit cards. And lastly, I wasn't sure that I really should include this, but I mean, this is passive income and I did not have to do anything to earn this money, but I decided to include the $1,200 stimulus check for this month. So yeah, that government stimulus plan that they sent out money to everyone, I got $1,200 from that, so I included it for April. So that brings me to grand total passive income earned in April. Again, this is not all realized money. This is just earnings. My total was $10,415.10. That is why I think it is really great to keep track of this stuff. When the market has a good month and your investment accounts rebound, that really helps as far as passive income goes. This was a good month because my retirement account at work went back up like I know that it would. Yes, the stock market goes down. You hear all this negative news about it, but y'all, over time, it will go back up. So this is why it's important not to panic sell. As a contrast, in March, the markets were down, and so I had a $10,000 month here in April, but in March I only earned $503.61. So yeah, that just goes to show how crazy the markets have been recently. And even if you go back to February, I only earned $128.33 in February. So yeah, a $10,000 month is great. And that should wrap it up for this month. I mean, I'm glad to see the markets returning, but at the same time, I kind of wish they would have stayed down just a hair longer so that I could invest more while the markets were low. But it seems like, at least thus far, that the recovery has been fairly quick for this market downturn. We'll see what happens in the future. Nobody knows what's going to happen with the markets in the short-term future. But again, over the long term, I expect them to rise, so I am going to continue what I have been doing and keep investing. All right, y'all, thanks for watching this video. I tried to keep it on the shorter side. I appreciate it if you made it all the way to the end, and I'll see y'all in my next one. Bye.